Hey everyone, welcome back to 3D Natives Lab. I'm Elliot, and in today's episode, we're putting the Raise3D DF2 Plus to the test. When I first unboxed the Raise3D DF2 Plus, I was intrigued. Having tested various resin 3D printers over the years, I was curious to see how this one would stand out. The DF2 Plus builds upon the DF2 platform with a more powerful light source, which translates to faster printing speeds and compatibility with a broader range of resins. But beyond the specs, what truly caught my attention was the user-centric design, particularly the integration of RFID technology across the printer, wash, and cure stations. RFID, which stands for radio frequency identification, is the same technology used for wireless entry calls in buildings and contactless payment. This feature promised a streamlined workflow, and I was eager to see how it performed in practice. Let's start with the hardware. The Raise3D DF2 Plus builds on the DF2's foundation by sharing most of its components. It offers a build volume of 200 by 112 by 300 mm and uses a 2560 by 1440 pixel resolution projector that provides sharp details on every print. The Z-axis is extremely sturdy too. Raise3D didn't skimp here, with a 10 kg load capacity that ensures smooth vertical movement and stability throughout the print. The user interface is also really clean and responsive, thanks to the large touchscreen at the front of the machine. What really makes a DF2 Plus stand out, though, is its upgraded light source. Raise3D collaborated with Texas Instruments to incorporate a much more powerful projector than the one found in the original DF2. This allows for significantly faster printing with advertised print speeds of up to 100 mm per hour, depending on the resin. With this bump in performance, the DF2 Plus can handle a broader selection of materials, including tougher, more technical resins that require a more intense light source to cure properly. The DF2 Plus also comes with an automatic resin feeding unit to help make sure you don't run into issues mid-print. As for availability, the DF2 Plus comes in a few different bundle options. You can get the printer alone for €3,499 or go with a full ecosystem package that includes DF wash and the DF cure stations for €5,999. There's also the less powerful DF2 model still available starting at €2,499, depending on your needs and budget. Now, onto the software. Raise3D continues to rely on their tried and true slicing software, Idea Maker, which now includes a dedicated DLP mode for the DF2 and DF2 Plus. The software includes resin-specific tools like anti-aliasing, automatic support generation, contour compensation, and even suction cap detection, all of which are important for ensuring successful prints. On top of all this, Raise3D has also developed a cloud platform called Raise Cloud. While the DF2 Plus isn't fully integrated with it yet, it's worth mentioning because it's already available for their other printers. Accessible via computer or smartphone, it allows you to send, monitor, and manage your prints wirelessly, which is especially useful for teams working across different departments or locations. I imagine we'll see more integration with Raise Cloud in the future for this machine as well. So, let's talk about actual performance, because that's where things get interesting. I tested the DF2 Plus with three of Raise3D's official resins, the standard, the high detail, and the TOF 2K. Across all three, the print quality was extremely consistent. That said, one issue I did run into was that the prints tend to stick a little too well to the build plate. In several cases, removing them caused the base of the part to chip or break, which is likely due to some overcuring or overexposure on the initial layers. It's something I think Raise3D could help mitigate by tweaking the material slicing profiles and providing different pre-configured profiles. They do have a dedicated support base online, and while it's helpful, I'd love to see more practical instructions added. Things like how to properly change the resin or a clear explanation of the recommended resin filling procedure. From my testing, it seems you have to first fill the vat manually with resin and then place the cartridge onto the auto-feeding station. It works, but it's not immediately obvious the first time you try it. One nice addition to the ecosystem is the external auto-feeding station. It simplifies resin management a lot, especially for longer prints. But if I'm being honest, I prefer it to be integrated directly into the printer, like it is on some other resin machines in this category. Having to swap out the tubes and pump whenever you change resin types adds friction, and you need to do that to prevent cross-contamination. An integrated system could have made that entire process much smoother. What I really appreciate about the DF2 Plus ecosystem is the level of automation in the workflow. After slicing your model in ID Maker, you can either send the file directly to the printer or load it via USB. Once the printer's done, you just take the build plate over to the DF wash, and the RFID tag on the plate tells the wash station exactly how long to run for. Then, when you're ready to cure the part, you just tap the plate against the DF cure station and it automatically configures the correct settings. It's incredibly intuitive and makes the entire post-processing phase feel seamless, especially when you're wearing gloves and don't want to be fiddling with touchscreens or going back to your computer to look up parameters. All in all, the Raise3D DF2 Plus is a very well-rounded resin 3D printer that's clearly built with professionals in mind. It brings high performance, fast print speeds, and extended material compatibility, all wrapped in a system that's intuitive and thoughtfully designed. I especially like the RFID-powered workflow. It's one of those small touches that makes a big difference in day-to-day use. Of course, it's not perfect. I think the base adhesion could use some fine-tuning. It would be nice to see clearer guidance on things like resin changing or filling procedures. And while the external auto-feeding station works well, I do think integrating it directly into the printer would be a step forward. That being said, Raise3D has done a great job identifying the real pain points in resin printing and addressing them with elegant, user-focused solutions. If you're a professional or even an advanced hobbyist looking for speed, reliability, and a better overall workflow, the DF2 Plus is definitely a machine worth checking out. All things considered, after rating the Raise3D DF2 Plus with our usual criteria, it scored 9.3 out of 10. To learn more about this printer and discover the breakdown of its score, check out our written article on 3Dnatives.com. And that wraps up our test of the DF2 Plus. But stay tuned, we're also expecting to test Raise3D's SLS 3D printer in the next few months, and I can't wait to share that one with you. As always, if you've got any questions or remark, drop a comment below, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye then, as always, happy printing.